Hey guys, so if you're new here, or if you're not, if you want to hear me voice act, head over to our main channel, links down below. And if you don't, this channel's solely for TTS. If you want to know all the details about what's going on, we have a stream up that you can go and watch, but let's just get into the video.
The toilets of the 41st millennium. A while back, an industrious Ritterfag made up some pretty funny descriptions for what toilets would be like in the Warhammer 40k universe. Great toilet stalls of the Space Marines. While Space Marine power armor can recycle the waste and use it as nutrients, many chapters have their own toilets. Black Templars, fairly difficult to use, because every time you do something in it, the fucking thing rushes at you. Blood Angels, aesthetically pleasing, but when on the toilet, one may be overcome by the brown rage. Blood Ravens, still looking for theirs. They happen to have several from other chapters though. Fucking thieves. Black Dragons, relatively normal, but after you use it, you get hard. And I'm not talking about a boner. Crimson Fists, in short supply from the Orc assault on Rin's world. Dark Angels, only the inner circle knows where it is. But I'm fairly certain their master of the forge is interred on it. Death Watch, only a few in existence, but are amongst the best and all tailored to taking various kinds of shits. Exorcists, as part of their training they are exorcised of the demon of Tarko shits, so they always go easy and quick. Flame Falcons, is specifically made to be able to flush burning shits. Flesh Tearers, is very likely to give you the nastiest case of the brown rage you've ever seen. Grey Knights, the most powerful toilets in the Imperium, inscribed with Aegis Wards, purity seals, and psychic barriers to prevent demonic possession and clogging. Imperial Fists is horribly uncomfortable because the Emperor is probably fairly uncomfortable on his throne. They can also be used as emergency bunker emplacements if the Battle Brother is attacked while on the toilet. Iron Hands, toilet may in fact be a sleeping Iron Father. Iron Snakes, the toilet is fine, but you get only one sheet of paper on account of you taking only one shit. Lamenters, perfectly fine until they try to flush. It always, always clogs, and overflows. Legion of the Damned, appears before you precisely when needed, but only if you have to go number 3. Mantis Warriors, due to their penance of a 100 year crusade without Imperial aid, they are drastically low on toilet paper. Also have multilasers. Mentors, contains a mini library so they can learn as they take a shit. Minotaurs, shit really fast in enemy toilets before running away. The very best toilets in the Imperium, but they sometimes have to share them with the High Lords of Terror. Sometimes steal those belonging to other chapters. Raven Guard, cannot be flushed as Korax himself mandated only he could do away with what was done as it is his responsibility. Salamanders, well made, efficient and beloved by the people. The only fault one can find is the use of lava when flushing. Space Wolves, a fire hydrant surrounded with dog biscuits. Ultramarines, immaculate and clean, everyone hates them for this reason. Minius Kalga's chair. White Scars, mounted on the weapons platform of an attack bike. Raptors, none. Shitting isn't a strategically viable action unless it is to cheaply produce desert camo for their armor. Astral Knights, they used Necron Overlords as toilets and wiped with the skin of dead flayers. Celestial Lions, they shit in a jar and keep it so they can tell stories about how glorious the said shit was to initiates. Marines Malevolent, they don't have any due to royally pissing off the Admech, and by extension, everyone else. So they improvise by taking a dump inside of a water tank meant for refugees so they can piss off the salamanders. Why? Because they're spiteful and gigantic douchebags, that's why. Soul Drinkers, their toilets turn into spider-legged mutants whenever shat into. Guardians of the Covenant, they are not sure if the toilets actually exist. Debates are ongoing. Relictors, most likely to be warped tainted and absolutely not hygienic. Space Sharks, covered in tribal symbols and has a complimentary stress ball to help the Marines keep their cool, which is a monumental task. Sons of the Phoenix, their toilets bear a striking similarity to those of the Third Legion before their fall from grace, though, They insist that their toilets are modeled off those used by the Imperial Fists. Toilets of the esteemed chapters of TG40K. Angry Marines. Like all Marines, they have their own toilets, but due to their diet of pizza, tacos, cheap booze and swearing, ingested by others shouting it into their faces, they have the most toxic and vile shits in the Imperium, unless you count the Death Guard when they were still loyal. This means that their toilets are equally vile and wretched, as nobody in their right minds would go near such a toilet to clean it without Terminator armor and a heavy flamer, or a really unlucky serf with a sponge and a death wish. The Angry Marines do, however, have the finest toilet paper in the galaxy, to ensure that their assholes are suitably cleaned of the previous shit skid marks. This is mostly in the form of copies of the Codex Astartes, although this is in short supply due to fiery aggressors using ground-up codexes and their flame weapons, which is printed on surprisingly soft and absorbent paper. If an angry marine wants a supremely cleaned and soft butthole, however, and doesn't mind risking being thrown out of an airlock, then they can try and use the role of emergency purity seals owned by Reclusi Arkmofo, and marines who have done so say that my shithole has never felt so clean. It was like wiping my ass with a field full of bunnies. Right, double quotation mark. Galactic Partridges. All of the toilets on their home planet of Petri use the finest quality silver for the citizens. All members of the esteemed Partridges use diamond encrusted golden toilets, while the chapter master prefers to use the one that was gifted from the Space Wolves chapter master Logan Grimner. The stalls also have monitors which allow the Partridges to view their many glorious victories over the millennia. All glory to the Partridges. Pretty Marines shit rose petals and piss liquid gold. Thus, no toilets. But if there were pretty marine toilets, they'd match the drapes and be embossed with beautiful diamonds and rubies and silver penises. Reasonable Marines, probably the only normal civilian brand toilets in the entire Imperium. Sleepy Marines, specially made to deal with the gallons of acidic piss they accumulate on their long hibernations. Blood Jaggers, makes the flesh tearers look like the pretty Marines with its brown rage inducement. No tabletop RPG is complete without beautiful models on the table, and the best place to get models is from us. If you check the link below, we have everything you could need for your magical realm. Only the finest of big titty wafers here. But if you're not into models or don't play with models, we got you covered with subclasses such as the Gachimashi Wizards, the Simp Warlock and the North FC Fighter. Also, we have started selling 5th edition adventures, with our first one featuring Belle Delphine, the succubus that has poisoned the town's well and turned the villagers into simps. If any of that stuff sounds fun to you, go ahead and check the link below, but let's get back to the video. Demonic Toilets of the Warp. Bloodletter, Bloodthirster, they shit brimstone and piss lava, so their toilets are active volcanoes. Juggernaut, Fleshhound, they feel no need to relieve themselves because of the enchanted collars of Khorne. As a result, gutting one may result in an explosion of fiery fesses, which is how they naturally relieve themselves. Demonette, Keeper of Secrets, their excretions contain soporific musk and they like to smear it all over themselves, eliminating the need for a toilet. Nurgling, they are already little shits, probably even the putrid turds of Papa Nurgle himself. Comma, therefore, the physical realm is Nurgle's personal toilet, with the little stinkers already flooding. Plagabra, Slimehound, if any toilet would be tough enough to contain the horribly disgusting shit of these creatures, it would be the throne of Grandfather Nurgle himself. Great Unclean One, they need no toilets as they shit out fully formed Nurglings. Horrors, both kinds, they magic their ways to random locations like right under your foot when you take a step, which causes Tsinj to mutter just as planned. Flamers of Tsinj, the Lords of Change are trying to devise a toilet that can weaponize their fiery shit. Screamers of Tsinj, sometimes, they swoop down low over Imperial tanks and let loose. It is incredibly hard to clean. Lord of Change, they magic their shit around just like Horrors, but they have considerably more control over where their waste ends up. Accursed Toilets of the Chaos Space Marines. Alpha Legion, any toilet may in fact be an Alpha Legion toilet, Alpha Legionnaire. Black Legion, no toilets of their own, though they were constantly trying to use the ones on Cardia, but then they blew Cardia up, So now they're trying to use the ones on Terra. Come on, man. You've been on the toilet for the past 10,000 years. Close bracket. Blood Disciples. There's a jump axe mounted. Death Guard. Trust me, you don't wanna use them. Mortarion's toilet is Nurgle's biggest cauldron where he mixes diseases. Emperor's Children. Everyone takes turns being the toilet. Iron Warriors. Difficult to get to with all the razor wire and trenches. May turn out to have merely been a decoy with no actual toilet in there. Percherabo has not been seen taking a toilet break, which raises questions about the enlarged back and hip portions of his Terminator armor. Night Lords. Stall walls are covered in horrible graffiti art. Closet with bat wings constantly screams and a jump pack attached. Surrounded by peepholes, leaving one in constant terror that they might be observed. Red Corsairs. Toilets are stolen from loyalist stalls. Huron Blackheart's personal commode is made as a crude mockery of the Golden Throne and is a contender for the most twisted and mutated toilet in the galaxy. Sons of Malice. They have no toilets of their own, but they will shit a pipe clogger in loyalist and in chaos toilets alike. Malil may bless a son of Malice with a toilet when necessary, but only by stealing the toilet from someone else who desperately needed a shit as well. The Sons of Malice do produce the best ghost shits in honor of their patron god. Thousand Sons. While Rubric Marines are using cat litter, aspiring sorcerers are using very comfortable gold-covered closets which are also blessed by Rubric of Ahriman. When Magnus does, his shit may appear on any time and in any place in the galaxy, totally randomly. Wordbearers. Fairly normal aside from the hymns playing in the stall speakers, until you realize it's out of paper and must ask the dark gods for some. Tsinch might bless you with the softest paper to ever caress your anus, or sandpaper, or something in between. Slaanesh will give you a blob with writhing tentacles and tongues. Khorne will just make you go into a berserker rage over the lack of TP for your bunghole, and you don't wanna know what Nurgle will give you. What about Undivided? Comma, if you're Undivided, then you won't need to wipe since the dark gods have clearly given you the gift of a filthy, itchy ass that makes you angrily scratch for relief and wishing for a change in underpants. Lorga seems to still be sitting on his porcelain throne, while Erebus possibly uses the same giant Reese's goblet he then drinks from, hence his sheer douchiness. World Eaters. Mostly destroyed when berserkers enrage while trying to figure out how to flush the toilets. World Eaters piss blood and shit skulls anyway, so they don't need toilets, with the exception of Angron, who might just calm down and ease up on the bloodlust if he finds one suitable to him. Other toilets of the Imperium. Adeptus Arbites, used for torturing suspects more than actual defecation. Adeptus Custodes, eternally waiting for the Emperor to get finished using it. Thankfully, Custodes' biology allows them to eternally recycle their shits, preparing the perfect shit for when the Emperor does return and frees up the Golden Throne. Adeptus Auroritus. Actually, we don't know. There isn't a men's room, so we couldn't see. It probably just sets the waste on fire anyway. Close bracket. Adeptus Mechanicus. What few toilets we could find had Bluetooth link-ups to monitor regularity and were Wi-Fi hotspots? Also involved a built-in servitor for no good reason. Plus any Mechanicus operative ranking Tech Priest or above do not need toilets, and have wall-mounted, vacuum-powered docks to vacate the bio-waste built up in specialized personal canisters on the Mechanicus operative themselves. The waste is then shot to a regionally centralized septic facility and housed in enormous septic processing tanks where microorganisms reprocess the waste into biofuel, algal nutrient, or fertilizer for biospheres or for the wealthy Margos gardens or houseplants. Explorators and other off-world agents have incredibly micro-sized versions of these bioprocessing plants installed on their chassis for continued waste relief on the go. This information courtesy of the Adeptus Septic of Mars ++++. Administratum. Must fill out 600 forms in triplicate before being able to relieve yourself. Must then fill out 500 forms in triplicate to flush. Where did you think Imperium gets their toilet paper? The Assassinorum. Culexus use the headgear of slain sickers. Vindicare use their gunk to coat bullets. Calidus poses enemies so they can shit pipe cloggers in enemy toilets. Vanus toilets have Wi-Fi stations attached to continue hacking. Venonym use the nearest access to enemy water supply and Eversa don't have toilets. When they are awakened, they are told the enemy has won and that is the true reason of their frenzied attacks and the truth behind their deadly explosions. They are really a shit of a bang. Armageddon Steel Legion. The Steel Legion guardsmen pipe all their shit together into a septic pattern hellhound. 10 soldiers replete with fully hygienic suits and gas masks drive it to the enemy lines. Then locking the drive shaft and priming a melter charge as a parting gift, they jump from the tank and run like hell to the nearest river to witness the shitstorm. And latrine duty has never been more awesome. Cadians, austere, but quite effective. The only problem is that it's even money that you'll have to fight a fucking lunatic Dow Checano for the stall, before and after you sit. Got blown the fuck up, and now the Cadians have nowhere to sit down to shit. Hence their new motto, Cardia stands. Catechins. Don't need them, as they smear their waste on their knives or on themselves for better camouflage when they can restrain themselves from simply hurling it at enemy soldiers to kill them. Death Corps of Krieg. The soldiers of Krieg build special holes, connected to their trenches, where they do their shits. All the toilets are also fallback positions from which to mount an assault to take back a trench, and in the most dire of circumstances can be crawled through to reach the rear lines. Are also the home of the Death Corps engineers, who only feel comfortable in the most vile and dank tunnels. Rural is a great app available on the Apple and Google Play Store as well as desktop for creating beautiful 8-bit character art. The app has 14 supported races, 150 plus weapons, 400 plus armor pieces for you to mix and match, 20 plus mini bases. There is that much to work from. I was able to make Cold Steel the Hedgehog, the God Emperor of Mankind, Pepe, and they are always adding more artwork. The app also has a character sheet to help keep track of everything during games. And if that wasn't enough, you can play about with the app for free with limited artwork. So go ahead, check it out, and if you decide to buy the app, use promo code NICKBEARDIA for 10% off and it lets them know we sent you. It's a great sponsor and a great app and we hope you guys go ahead and check it. But let's get back to the video. Imperial Guard. Each guardsman is equipped with a chamberpot. Soldiers who fail to recite the litany of smooth passage while using their chamberpot will be shot by the commissar after having horrible constipation. Company and regimental stalls compress the waste into tightly packed, high-density shells and then fires them at the enemy via rear-mounted cannon. Earthshakers aren't called earthshakers for nothing. Mordian Iron Guard. Every guardsman has his own toilet, and shits in perfect sync with the rest of the unit, often while being shot at. Tanith first, and only, appears without warning when you need to take a shit, and is gone by the time you've finished pulling your pants up. Talon. No toilet. Standard procedure is to bury waste in sand. Valhallan 597th. Appears normal, but the cleanest, most efficient, and best looking stall is conspicuously hidden behind the rest, next to the nastiest stall in the Imperium. Also, all their seats are made of ice. Tarex Guard. Waste is chemically treated and repurposed as the primary ammunition for Bane Wolves. Vostroyans. Every toilet is finely crafted using wood and copper, accented with even more shinies like gold. Of course, if you can't build your own toilet or inherit one, you're out of luck. Heraconia Lysian drop troops, they like flinging their waste off high places. Creed has never been witnessed going to the bathroom, but somehow his turds show up in any stall Abaddon the Despoiler tries to use. It must be the work of his tactical gen Creed. Kiernel Commissar Ibram Gaunt discovers an STC capable of producing flush toilets but destroys it, correctly perceiving that it has been tainted by chaos for no clear reason. Sarfus Kane uses standard Imperial toilets, but whenever he goes into a public lavatory, if he knew what he was getting himself into by entering a stall, he would have rather charged into the Eye of Terror with nothing but a roll of sandpaper. Instead of flushing, he will accidentally kill some horrible Chaos Hellspawn Xenomanipulator Mutant Abomination, thereby saving the Imperium. Inquisitorial Toiletry. When an Inquisitor drops his pants and sits down, a malfunction in the toilet programming may cause the toilet cleaning servitor to code an exterminatus order into the Inquisitor's data slot. That's why so many worlds are being purged these days. Demon Hunters. The best toilets in the Imperium, capable of flushing any amount of waste with impossible ease. Unfortunately, they are highly expensive and after you use them, there's a possibility of mind scrubbing or summary execution. Witch hunters, purge your waste with holy promethium in the name of the Emperor. Allegedly involve repentant heretics being used as an alternative. Eileen hunters, classified by order of the Holy Audace of the Emperor's Inquisition for suspected use of xenotechnology. Allegedly involve actual xenos being used instead. Foul toilets of the xenos. Elder toiletry. The very existence of elder toilets is debatable, since the book Xenology suggests that elder may, in fact, excrete crystal, which accounts for the copious amount of gemstones on anything the elder make. Elder toilets, coupled with a diet of cheese and spicy foods, are designed to make shitting as uncomfortable as possible. Rumor has it that Eldred Ulthran designed the currently used forms. Each craft world likes their turds disposed of a little differently. All toilets teleport their waste through the webway to preset points in space and time, causing little bits of elder shit to land atop your helmet at just the wrong moment. Just as planned. Same Han screams around at insane speeds throughout the craft world, allowing the user to engage in flying joust matches of doom while relieving himself. A Latok. Their toilets are experimental sniper rifles that use elder turds for projectiles. Iandan. Iandan toilets are wraithbone constructs that extract the souls of elder shits and inter them within the toilet itself, creating a gestalt fecal consciousness. Beeltan toilets sing hymns of ancient glories and fill the she with desire to kill all untermensch xenos. Harlequin toilets are elegant and covered in smiley faces and checkerboard patterns. They don't flush after use, but seal off and shrink so they can be carried into battle and the contents emptied onto the enemy. Dark Elder. Do you really want to stick an exposed part of your body inside something made by the Dark Elder? Or expose a bodily orifice to something made by the Dark Elder? And the overwhelming fanboy response is, yes. Kabali toilets actually seem innocent at first glance. Well, apart from the excess spikes, it will often turn out to be booby-trapped and will launch poison spikes into the buttocks of whoever tries to use them, preferably a hierarchical superior. Witch cults do not need toilets. Once they're finished cutting up their enemies, they dump in the bleeding wounds of whichever ones are still alive. Scourges just make like the creatures they took their wings from. They do their business on the wing, preferably onto the face of someone who stared at them for too long. Incubi sects have access to ancient, amazing toilets rumored to date from before the fall, but only a few have the right to use them. The only way to obtain the right to use them is to kill someone who has it in a duel. Most of the time, any Dark Elder or human naive enough to sit on a toilet from a homunculus coterivus will get horribly tortured and raped by a grotesque disguised as a toilet. Other times the toilets usually have barbed pins on the seats or acid packs in the flush mechanism. The homunculi themselves have much more efficient methods for disposing of their waste, such as collecting it in a colostomy bag to coat their poisoned blades with. In Asdrubial Vec's presence, you are the toilet. TAU toiletry. TAU. Each cast has its own specific type of toilet. The Fire cast's toilets are optional war gear for their battle suits. The Earth cast install toilets right into their worker drones, in case they need to pinch a loaf while designing said battle suit. The air cast simply shit into long vials. Their long, slender bodies produce long, slender shits, and use them as bombs in air raids. The water cast will simply fashion a toilet out of the bodies of the Imperial diplomats that declare war on them. The ethereals have evolved to the point where they shit morale in its purest, sweetest form. And they don't even need to wipe afterward. Croot. Quietly spread throughout the galaxy to every species. With every subsequent flush, the toilet becomes more and more adapted to handling that species' shit. Vespid, recycle their waste to build hives. Farsight Enclave, of the highest caliber technology, but only one is allowed per 3 battalions. Many are also cracked, dirty, and fixed many times. They're also very low and tell the user that he needs to shorten his reach. Commander Farsight's personal field commode glows with strange energy and vaporizes any dung that falls into it. Guvisa, TAU give porto potties to human settlements as to encourage joining the greater good. They're so helpful they even wipe for you. The disinfectant it sprays afterwards, however, may render you sterile and then tag you to be escorted to a work and re-education camp, depending on your answers to the mandatory psychological survey hooked up to biofeedback monitors on the seat. Other assorted plumbing. Orc, painted red. Has a mounted big shooter and bigger chopper in case there's a line and the other boys are getting impatient. It only flushes because they truly believe it has a plumbing system. In some cases, however, orky bogs are actually a sneaky grot trick to loot your ass. Squigs are of course mandatory. Necron, ever wonder what those monoliths were originally designed for? Effects vary depending on which setan. Nightbringers, reaches up into your rectum, and pulls out your entire large intestine, turds and all. Void dragons, leaves you with a robotic ass and no need to ever crap again. Deceivers, the best toilet in the universe, but it either flushes backwards or takes you along for a ride. Outsiders, ashamed of its stench, it built a Dyson sphere so nobody would have to smell it. Tyrannid bio toilets, actually a subspecies of gaunt. Squats, they're short, wide and full of beer, but no one believes they exist anymore. Now canon. Malol, trying to destroy all other chaos toilets but none believes he exists. Diasporics, extra tough to handle the waste of various species. Toilet seat is shape and size adjustable. Believed mostly destroyed by iron hands at the end of the 31st millennium. Interakes, hole shaped without the head. Strangely mobile and mechanical. Well guys, hope you enjoy today's video. We are going to assume you have if you have stayed to the end. Consider subscribing and clicking the notification bell if you really enjoyed it to stay up to speed with any and all new videos. Also check out the links below to our shop for some fat ass titties and our sponsor Rural, and be sure to use the promo code at checkout so they know we sent you and you'll get 10% off. And until next time. Thank you.